Hi guys, welcome to another segment of Legal Friday with me, Francine. So a couple of weeks ago, I got a question that really prompted me to start doing or to think about start doing segments on publishing. So the question was, why would someone choose to go with a traditional publisher as opposed to going with a vanity press, as opposed to even publishing on their own as a self-published author? And I thought that was a really great question. And again, it prompted me to make a decision to start doing some of these segments on publishing. And let me also say, one of my girlfriends, who's the editor at a traditional publishing house, has agreed to do an interview with me. And I don't know if I'll do the whole interview, if I'll update the whole interview, or if I'll upload maybe portions of it over a few weeks. But anyway, she's agreed to do it. So that's really great. So you'll get a perspective from an editor as well. Okay, so back to the question, why would someone choose traditional publishing as opposed to some other avenue? So the first thing, and this is one of the most important reasons, whether it's a reason that's important to you or not, and that is prestige. There's a certain amount of cachet that's attached to someone being published by one of the big five, for example, Penguin Random, Hachette, Macmillan, Simon & Schuster, or HarperCollins. Again, it might not matter to you, but it might matter to some people. And if I'm telling you the truth, it mattered to me a few years ago when my first book got published. So my first book was published by Random House, and that was before Penguin and Random merged together. In 2003, this is before they merged. My book, I want it to be published by a traditional publisher because, again, there's a certain amount of prestige that's attached to being published by one of the big publishers, one of the big traditional publishers. So that's one reason. Another reason why someone would go traditional is distribution in bookstores. Now, of course, it's a little different today because we don't have as many bookstores as we used to have, but we still have Amazon. And I'll tell you, it's a lot easier for one of the big traditional publishing houses to get onto Amazon than it would be for you as an individual. Is it impossible? Of course not. Of course it's not. But it's a lot easier for a HarperCollins to have a place on Amazon than it is for Joe Schmo. So that's another reason. Another reason why people might go traditional is you have a partner. You have a partner in crime, so to speak. You have someone that, you have an editor. They provide you with an editor at no cost. They provide you with marketing and promotional help. They provide you with a publicist, an in-house publicist. You get all of that as part of the package when you're working with a traditional publishing house. You also have access to big media. Now, again, things are a little different today. It's pretty easy for someone to build up a big platform on social media. And also, as a result of that, maybe get recognized by one of the TV stations. That said, not everybody's in a position to build a big campaign, nor build a big platform. And it's still easier for a HarperCollins or a Simon & Schuster or a Penguin Random to get access to big media than it would be for you. The other thing is they actually create and pay for your marketing materials. Now, there are some downsides to working with a traditional publisher. One of the downsides is you get a percentage of the proceeds. I mean, a tiny percent. And we call those royalties. The other thing is if you even get an advance from a traditional publisher, you got to pay it back. Or you have to, and you might not have to pay back the exact advance, but you can't get your royalties until that advance is paid back. So essentially, you got to pay it back. It's not a gift. Sometimes people think an advance is a gift. It is not a gift. There are no free lunches, especially when you're dealing with a traditional publishing house. The other thing is rarely do traditional publishers accept unagented or unsolicited proposals. The other thing is it's really hard to get published with one of the big traditional publishing houses. It's really hard. They don't accept everyone. The other thing is you might need, more than likely, you're going to either need a book lawyer, a publishing lawyer, or an agent to just help you sift through that contract. You know, a lot of authors think they understand those contracts and they want to go it all alone. Believe me, I've had some of those as my clients after the fact when they're trying to get out of the agreement. And it's almost impossible because when they should have had the lawyer or the agent was before they signed the agreement. Those contracts are drafted by lawyers. And some of them are like this thick. I mean, the shortest traditional publishing agreement I've ever seen, and I've negotiated a few of them, has been 30 pages. The biggest one has been 75. So you go do the math and just figure out how much you on your own, without any experience, would be able to understand what's in those agreements. Again, drafted by lawyers. So those are some of the things. Oh, one more thing. It takes a long time to get traditionally published in terms of the cycle. So it usually takes about 18 months or longer to actually get your book out there. So again, some things to think about if you are considering traditional publishing. The other option might be self-publishing. Now, if you want to go for self-publishing, there are several benefits. Number one, you get to control everything. You have creative control over the book cover, over the title of the book. You get to decide what colors, what fonts. You get to decide everything. You're the publisher. You get to decide. The other real big benefit of self-publishing is you get to keep all the proceeds. It's not about somebody giving you 5% or 7% or even 10% of the proceeds. You get to keep all of the proceeds after, of course, you pay your expenses. The other thing is the book is generally published a lot sooner because you're in control. So it's not about an 18-month cycle or a 3-year cycle. You get to decide. However long it takes you to get the work done will be how long it takes you to get the book out to market. The other thing is there are other immediate benefits for you as a self-published author. You actually get to decide whether it's going to be a soft cover, a hard cover, if you want to do it as a digital format, if you want to do it as an audio. You get to decide all of those things. Those are some of the benefits of self-publishing. On the other hand, some of the downside of self-publishing, sometimes, it is a pretty substandard product that you put out. Why? Because a lot of self-published authors think just because they're doing it themselves, they don't have to exercise the care that a traditional publisher might exercise, like really making sure the book is written well, making sure you have an editor, a competent editor reviewing the book. A lot of times self-published authors just think, okay, it's mine. I can do what I want, throw it out to press. And honestly, it's a piece of garbage. Unfortunately, that's what happens sometimes, which is why those books don't sell. The other thing is you're responsible as a self-published author for all of the upfront costs. I mean, all of them. That means you've got to pay for someone doing the editing. You've got to pay for some distribution. You've got to pay for printing. You've got to pay for everything. You've got to pay for the contracts, any contract you have. You've got to pay for everything. Also, if you're smart, you've got to pay for the lawyer who vets the work to make sure that you haven't, make sure that you've dotted all your I's and crossed all your T's. So the other thing is you're responsible for the marketing, all the promotion. You're responsible for securing distribution. You are responsible for everything. Plus, as a self-published author, it's not going to be as easy for you to get access to big media as it might be for a traditional publishing house. Another option might be vanity presses. So the benefit of going with a vanity, and sometimes they're called subsidy press. First, let me say this. What these are these publishing houses that have cropped up over the last few years. And what they've done is filled in a void. They've satisfied a need. So most of the time, the average person cannot get published by a traditional publisher. And maybe they don't want to invest the time or the energy or the money to figure out how to self-publish. So the vanity press came along and they fill that need. So number one, you can get published relatively quickly when you publish with a vanity press. Number two, and probably the biggest benefit, they accept everybody and anybody as long as you're willing to pay them. They will accept anyone. It doesn't matter who you are. You pay their price, they'll publish you. Number one, you can get help with editing. You can get help with marketing and promotion. You can order as many copies as you want or order as few copies as you want. Unlike if you were publishing with a traditional publisher, the first run, they might order 10,000 copies to see how things go. You don't have to order 10,000 copies if you're going with a Vanity Press. It's print on demand. So you can order 5 copies to test the waters. You can order 1,000 copies to test the waters, or you can order 1 copy to test the water. That's one of the benefits of going with a Vanity Press. The downside of working with a Vanity Press, number one, the end product is sometimes very substandard. And that will depend on the Vanity Press that you work with. The other thing is you have to pay a very hefty fee up front. Unlike a traditional publisher, the Vanity Press wants you to pay them to get published. The traditional publisher will pay you to get published, but the Vanity Press, they're wanting you to shell out a lot of bucks for them to publish your book. You know what I liken them to? Think about like 7-Eleven stores. 7-Eleven are convenience stores. And they filled in a void. You know, years ago when there weren't a lot of supermarkets that were open all night long, 7-Eleven was open all night. So the convenience of having access to a store, as a result, the prices were a lot higher. So same thing here. It's the convenience of publishing your book when either the traditional publisher won't, or you don't want to go that route, or you don't want to self-publish. As a result, they're charging you a lot of money to get published. They also, not only are they charging you a hefty fee up front, they also want a percentage of the proceeds. They're also charging you for editing. They charge you a separate price for marketing and promotion. It's like a la carte. They're charging you for every little thing. They're nickeling and diming you for the privilege of publishing your book. Plus, and here's one of the things I discovered as I've been negotiating some of these contracts for clients, they sometimes want to take your copyright. How do I know that? 3 of the agreements that I negotiated, fortunately, the client came to me in advance before they signed the contract. I was able to catch that and remove it from the agreement. But once a client came to me, after she had already entered into the agreement and she discovered after the fact that she had given up her copyright, she was livid. But honestly, by that time, it was really hard for me to do anything. She could have gone to court and fought them, but she would have been in court and she would have very likely lost. Why? Because she signed the contract. She signed it, whether she read it or not is irrelevant. She signed it, and the law assumes that if you sign something, you have read it. She didn't. She had to deal with the consequences afterward. Okay, that's it for now. 3 different types: traditional publishing, Vanity Press, or self-publishing. Those are some options. Think about it. And again, going back to the questions I asked you last week, what works for you? You know, are you interested in prestige? Are you interested in name? Are you more of a do-it-yourself kind of person? Are you somebody that doesn't mind getting your hands dirty, figuring out how to do self-publishing? If that's you, self-publishing might be a better route. Anyway, that's it for now. I'm Francine. This is Legal Friday with Francine. Until next week, have a great weekend. Bye-bye.